Number 1, Brian Holt. Number 20, Wesley Sharpie. Number 4, Meshack Jerome. Number 5, Shane McNierney. Number 10, JC Banks. Number 8, Christian Silva. Number 24, Yuma. Number 27, Derek Gebhardt. Number 11, Connor Doyle. And number 7, Joshua Castellanos. Holding the American flag today on the field, we have members from the Armada Youth Academy. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please stand and remove your hats for the singing of the national anthem by Katrina Cabrera. Katrina is a 14-year-old and is looking forward to being a ninth grader for Bartram Trail High School this fall. She loves performing all over Florida, from the Capitol down to Southern Florida, promoting awareness for foster care, adoption, and autism. She has recently played at the Daly's Place Amphitheater and has also joined opening up for Granger Smith in 2017.
Oh.
And we welcome you to Hodges Stadium on the campus of the University of North Florida. Cole Pepper along with Ryan Patridge as we get ready for a battle for the top of the table in the NPSL Sunshine Division. The Armada taking on Miami United here in Jacksonville. Ryan, this is an Armada side that currently is tied for the top spot in the division with Miami FC. Miami United just a shade behind. These are the three teams that are likely to make the postseason from this division. However, there is such a difference in being the number one seed and being the number two seed and being the number three seed, because the number three seed won't have a home playoff match at all. Number two seed will only host that first game against the three seed, and that number one seed can sit and wait after a first round bye. We're starting to get into the stretch here, and this is a crucial time for both of these squads.
Yeah, absolutely. Just looking forward to the rest of the schedule. The Armada do have some games at hand, which help them, but, you know, just looking, the home advantage for a playoff game would be huge, especially when it's a one-off championship match.
The Armada have faced Miami United before in some key matches, including in the U.S. Open Cup in the third round, and Miami United came away with a 2-0 victory over the Armada at JU, so a little bit of retribution here, perhaps. This is also really developing into quite the rivalry. These two sides met a week and a half ago in South Florida in Hialeah. And in that match, there was a sending off for both sides and a bevy of yellow cards pulled as well. This figures to be a hotly contested contest on a warm day here in Jacksonville.
Yeah, very warm today, so tempers may flare a little bit quicker than normal. Yeah, going back to the last match, the 10 cards and two sendings off, one for each group, was definitely a a fiery affair, and that's good. That's good for the team and for the league to build these derbies, these local rivalries, to have a little passion into the games, make them mean a lot more.
87 degrees at kickoff, and while you can see some of the shadows from the grandstand starting to creep across the pitch, the lights are on here at Hodges Stadium, but it is warm, and we'll see how much that impacts things as it goes on throughout the course of the match. Of course, the legs can give on you playing in this kind of heat and humidity. Both of these teams should be used to playing in the humidity, but still, it's got to have an impact on the game.
Yeah, definitely. You know, you're going to see the guys go for water at stoppages whenever they can. It's just going to be – it's very mentally draining more as much as it is physically to play in the humidity. It's not quite the heat, but the humidity. It's just tough to run in.
And the Armada will start with a three-man back line of Wes Sharpie, Shane McInerney, and Meshack Jerome. In the midfield, it'll be Christian Silva and J.C. Banks on the wings. Yuma and Connor Doyle in central midfield. And Derek Gebhardt will play an attacking midfield role with Kieran Kilduff up top and Joshua Castellanos playing off his shoulder. The Armada have also added a couple of players to the roster this week, a couple of former local college players, Mitchell Hopkins from JU and Micah Smoke from UNF. Armada in the dark navy blue, Miami United in the white with the multicolored stripes on the front, and we are underway here in Jacksonville. Here's Kilduff, the captain's armband on the big Irishman, and a whistle from behind the play. Connor Doyle took a knock. Beg your pardon, that was Sharpie. He took a knock and is down for the moment, and already some talking between the Armada and Miami United. Didn't take long to get tempers flaring just a touch between these two sides. Bautista Dominguez had a few things to say to Sharpie when both were on the ground. The Armada will play a possession style of soccer. For those of you who have not watched the Armada this year, they will control possession as much as possible. And one of the key players for the Armada is Meshack Jerome. He'll play a right back position in this three-man back line. The Haitian international, so key in terms of his physical presence and also his passing, one of the best long passers you'll see in American soccer.
Yeah, he strikes the ball very cleanly, and from that right center back, he will look to get forward and fill the holes in behind the wingers, and it's something that the Armada look to exploit.
Here's McCauley for Miami United. Door was shut on him by Jerome, and a corner kick coming for Miami United. When the Armada and Miami United met last, 9 days ago, it was Shelton Shamar who scored the goal for Miami United to equalize things. He's on the bench in this one. McInerney able to get ahead to it. And Yuma clears for Jacksonville for the moment. Kept in by Miami United. Looking at the division, it's fairly clear that there are three teams that are head and shoulders above the rest, with Miami FC, Miami United, and Jacksonville. But there is a bit of a spoil sport team. Palm Beach United is the only team to have beaten the Armada this year in NPSL play. They are also the only team to have beaten Miami United this year in NPSL play. And the Armada will take on Palm Beach United at home on Wednesday. So we'll keep a close eye on things as the playoffs approach.
Yeah, the Armada hold their fate in their own hands with their games in hand, but be a tough matchup on Wednesday against a team that can play a little bit of a spoiler role.
Just want to play it all the way back. Alusma Pierre. Long pass up ahead, and the offside flag was up. Pierre, one of the Haitians on the field, along with the Miami United goalkeeper, Oxenet Peterson. All will be very well familiar with the man who has the ball at his feet now, Meshack Jerome. Here comes Jerome, who played for Haiti against Argentina in a World Cup warm-up. Ahead to Kilduff, tries to chip the keeper. Didn't get enough on it and falls harmlessly into Peterson's hands. Peterson had a tremendous performance in the U.S. Open Cup matchup against the Armada earlier this year. And he'll be one to watch in goal for Miami United.
Like the proverb says, he stood on his head in that match to keep them in the game. And, you know, pretty much a little bit but upset if you watch the match. You know, definitely wasn't a game that the Armada felt like they should have lost, but definitely one that they're thinking about. They want to get it back.
In the short history between these two sides, the Armada have never beaten Miami United. in NPSL play. Last year, the Armada did beat Miami United in a U.S. Open Cup match. That was when the Armada were playing in the North American Soccer League, of course. McInerney, a long one to his countryman, Kieran Kilduff. And played out. It'll be a throw-in for Jacksonville here. Early stages here at Hodges Field. Little tap ahead. Here's Gebhardt on the run. He'll use his pace. One of the faster players in the NPSL. This one swung in toward the penalty spot. And Silva coming right down the middle, but elevated it too much. Good opportunity there for the Armada, but they can't convert.
Yeah, good flank play, good ball in. Silva liked to have that one back. Caught a little bounce on the way in and caught on the way up, but something that, you know, two pretty good chances in the first opening 5 minutes, so warning signs are there, you know, to look to get an early goal.
The Armada are coming off a club record performance. They scored 7 goals on Sunday in a win over Boca Raton. 2 from J.C. Banks, 2 from Joshua Castellanos, 1 from Doyle, 1 from Kilduff, and 1 from Christian Silva. So this should be a confident group on the attack, if nothing else. Mark Lowry said of that match, it's what we've been expecting for a while, to take the shots and score the goals like we did. It's something special. It's something we've been threatening to do. They just haven't always been as efficient in the final third. And last touch has sometimes eluded the Armada. Here's Gebhardt again, sending one across the face of the goal. And Banks can't track it down. It'll be a throw-in for Miami United.
Yeah, the Lowry's philosophy is to keep the ball in attack, and they've shown a little bit more, you know, I just say impatience, but that's the word, not being so patient around the top of the box and trying to be a little more direct. And, you know, it finally caught on, and they finally found a way to stick the balls in the back of the net the last match. But I think with Kilduff, you know, he's got a goal in each of his last 3 matches. He would like to continue that streak, and you know, he's a forward playing with confidence. He's a dangerous forward, so like to see. I know he'd like to have that early chance back, but like to see him get more involved, maybe get another early goal.
4 goals for Kieran Kilduff this season for the Armada, including one in the U.S. Open Cup. Throw in for the Armada from one of the last patches of sunshine on the pitch. Now here's Silva, who will bring it forward. Long ball for Kilduff, who's onside. Can he get there in time? Yes, he does. Now back to Gebhardt. Gebhardt chips one. A little too much finesse perhaps that time. Nobody making that back post run, and Peterson able to grab it easily. And a yellow card pulled on Miami United. Must have been something said. Elusma Pierre has the early yellow.
Yeah, he must have said something to the referee or to a player about something going on. But going back to that last little sequence with Gebhardt, I'd like to see him square that defender up and take him on instead of trying to hit that early ball. I know he wants to cut back into his stronger right foot on the left flank, but I would like to see him just be a little more, show a little patience and maybe take that player on and get him unbalanced. And it also gives your forwards and your runners enough more time to get into the box.
Keep an eye on Pierre, who draws the early yellow card here in just the 7th minute. Kilduff comes back for it. Wes Sharpie. Now Connor Doyle. Tried to shoot one between 2 Miami United defenders. Pierre got in the way. Throw in for Jacksonville from right in front of the Armada bench.
It's an interesting shape from Miami United tonight. Looks like they're playing almost like a 3-3-3-1 with 3 center backs and a holding midfielder and wingers with a single target forward. Not a system you see very often.
And certainly 3 on the back line and occasionally dropping a player depending on defense. The Armada also with a 3-man back line, but again, they'll do the same and defend with 4 if necessary or 5, depending on the attacking position. Something that Mark Lowry has talked about, the player movement within the system that the Armada are utilizing, different than really anybody else in American soccer. There are some other clubs who employ certain aspects of what the Armada have done, but in terms of the full package, you won't see player movement like this in any other club, according to Lowry.
Yeah, they're very fluid. You know, you get the schematic of how they're lining up at the beginning of the match, and it rarely, you know, other than, you know, a center back and Yuma sitting in front of the backs, is really, they're pretty much free to go wherever they want, as long as the team shape and the team balance is kept. You know, Gebhardt's drifting wide. You know, Kilduff always runs through the middle, but it's almost, you know, as long as you run forward, I can take your spot. We can keep our shape, and we can be a little unpredictable that way.
Here's Banks. Now Silva. Dispossessed. He'll work to try to get it back, but instead sent all the way back to Fernando Hernandez for Miami United. Now here's Daryl Gordon working it forward. Chipped over the top. Offside flag is up as Brian Holt comes off his line. It was offside nonetheless. And you can see that looks to be Miami's approach here. Try to spring somebody either on a counter or something over the top. The Armada looking like a side that's willing, at least in the early stages, to play the ball along the ground more often than Miami United. Although we have certainly seen in the past, Miami United has been a club that wants to possess the ball as well.
Yeah, that last little movement, the center forward checked deep and a midfielder ran in from behind him, but you know, I have to blame the runner because he saw the pace in the pass and when it can be served, and he continued his run. Good discipline from the Armada back three to push up high and catch him offside. But it is a slippery slope to play on. One missed call by a referee, and we're not afforded the ability and the, you know, a VAR that they're using at the World Cup now, but you know, it's a dangerous game to play, but it does work.
Little pushing and shoving there in the middle. Cesar Tejera was warding off Joshua Castellanos. Finally got the call. Now Pierre, a long ball ahead, looking for Micoli, but over the head of everybody and easily handled by Brian Holt. The pace of this one is about as you would expect in heat like this.
Yeah, you're going to have a little burst of energy, burst of excitement, I guess you could say, and, you know, with, you know, interrupted with long stretches of possession. It's going to be a very stop-start game, I have a feeling, just due to the – because players are going to try to foul to stop the tempo, to stop counters, to catch their breath, things like that, because, you know, it is oppressively humid and muggy on the field at field level. It's down there earlier today, and it was hot.
And now a little shove on Castellanos. Thomas Granito, who really made his stamp on the game in the U.S. Open Cup match, played very well for Miami United. Now Gebhardt again turning on the Jets down the wing, eluding another Miami defender. Gebhardt tried to get all the way across to J.C. Banks. It was intercepted by Miami United, but Yuma able to rise and keep it in. Here's Banks. Banks coming off a two-goal performance last time out in that 7-0 Armada victory over Boca Raton. The Armada scored early, and they scored often in that match. Again, Gebhardt turning on the Jets. Pretty clear that there isn't anybody to keep up with the pace of Gebhardt on that far side.
No, his pace is definitely electrifying, and probably in the scouting report they've identified that left-hand attacking channel, right-hand defending channel for Miami United as a potential spot to exploit when use his pace. You know, he's drifted out and almost become a true number 11, you know, and left a bigger hole in the middle of the field. You know, he was listed as a 10 in the pregame lineup, but he's drifted wide. I'm sure it was in the scouting report to exploit their right back.
A yellow card pulled on Fernando Hernandez for Miami United. So that's two yellow cards here in the opening 13 minutes.
And that's not a good yellow card to take if you're going to be matched up against his pace the rest of the match. That's something to exploit. They're going to look to do, because he now, any missed time tackle, any pull in the jersey, and Miami will be down to 10.
The Armada played a bit of the match against Miami United last time out with a man advantage before getting a red card themselves. Mikey Melvin was sent off. This one sent in. Banks in front all alone. Saved by Peterson. Offside flag was up.
Yeah, good movement from the set piece. Just ran a bit early. But you're very telling. The marking there was non-existent for Miami United.
Taking a little bit of a page out of Germany's book today on the Tony Cruz World Cup heroics. Hit it short. It was from a little further away, but the old put it on a tee for him.
Yes, great strike to get the 3 points that Germany desperately needed.
Here is Silva. He's dispossessed by Tejera. Miami United on the attack. A chance here. Holt off his line, and McCauley could not redirect it. May have been a little of Holt's presence there that impacted that scoring opportunity for Miami United.
Yeah, but that's sort of the drawbacks of playing a true three in the back is you're going to have gaps and you're going to have spaces for players to run through, and that's what they got caught with a little gap, a late runner, and Gebhardt didn't track back far enough, quick enough, and lost track of the runner through the box, and Meshack was the wrong side of the forward, and you know, fortunately, Holt did enough to put McCauley off on the shot.
All right, here's Castellanos.
What's this?
Now J.C. Banks. Now Banks. Armada with possession. Trying to get back on the attack here. All the way back to Holt. Now here's McInerney. Out wide for Meshack Jerome. There's a long pass from Jerome to J.C. Banks. Banks waiting for reinforcements. Now Silva. Steps by one. Now swings one into the box. Moment here for the Armada. Headed away. Yuma got a head to it. But Miami United able to clear it out for the moment now.
Good patient buildup from the Armada. Good ball in. You know, didn't beat the first defender. Couldn't get past the second. But Yuma did a good job of trying to keep the ball in the zone. And then, you know, unfortunate free kick to relieve the pressure.
So the Armada with another chance. This has sort of been one of the challenges for the Armada so far this year, and that is taking their chances. They've had opportunities. They've been able to create, but not always finish. There's Jerome interrupting for the moment. Now this one hit fairly meekly on the ground, easily handled by Holt. Daryl Gordon didn't get much on it. Beg your pardon, that was Schoenfeld.
Now the Armada sort of rely on the mathematics of just scoring goals by just sheer number of chances, and it's just to be something, you know, with the forwards in a little bit of a good run, you know, like to see these balls be converted into at least saves and not just misses or just half chances, though, just a way to make the goalkeeper work and make him earn the save.
Here's Gebhardt again. He plays Castellanos onside. Castellanos. Landed one in between Kilduff and J.C. Banks.
I'd like to see one more combination around the top of the box. Add come in and look to combine to pull that ball back from closer near the end line, you know, where he can put it back on the goal and have those Miami United defenders running back towards their own goal and maybe possibly score an own goal.
Miami now has dropped four back in defense at this moment.
That's something you'll see them do, especially when there's just a single target forward. A little rugby challenge.
Yep. Sharpie trying to get to it, could not. And more talking from Miami United.
Yeah, but it's just not efficient to keep three back to defend one striker, a single target forward. So you'll see the two of the three center backs will probably...
A ball shot wide. And then played out. It'll be a goal kick for Brian Holt.
But you'll see one of the – and it's something that the Armada do a good job of when they play against a single target forward is one of the – and normally it's Jerome will step forward into the attack to leave it. It's still a 2v1 in a covering situation for the other two center backs. But really, if you do the math, if you have three to defend one up front, you're going to be down a player somewhere else. So look for both back threes to turn into back twos or back fours to defend against one or three players.
Banks, a little heavy on the touch from Castellanos. And cleared out by Miami United. Meshack Jerome will head it back toward Brian Holt.
Hey, Jack, look up here, up by the press box. Those kids right there, I just told them to stop throwing things down. They were throwing things down.
Now here is Connor Doyle. The Armada have been a pretty patient bunch so far here through the opening 19 minutes plus. Certainly keeping possession. Now Doyle. Kilduff tracks it down for Jacksonville.
But the patience is good, but as they possess in the back, they need to walk forward and try to force Miami United back and not allow them to defend so high up the field. You know, patience is great, but if you never penetrate or you never try to get behind, there's no sense in it. Miami would be more than happy to sit back and try to hit the Armada on the break.
And on the counter, Cesar Tejera's ball a little too long. It'll be a throw-in for Jacksonville here. Again, this feels like we've seen a lot of these matches through the years in Jacksonville in the hot summer months. Season is starting to stretch out, and when you start playing games midweek and then three games in 8 days kind of thing, the pace can be a little herky-jerky just out of necessity when you start talking about how the legs respond. This one chipped into the box for Miami United, had Holt sprawling, but nothing on target for Miami United.
Yeah, the ball went in, good ball, early ball in. Good cutback, there's no runners. But going back to what you're talking about, three games in 8 days, legs, heavy legs, that's when your roster depth comes into effect. But, you know, unfortunately teams, you know, struggle at any level, not just this level with that sort of roster depth. And you're going to see it, you see it at every level. But here at this, it's just going to be tough for those guys because you're going to have to rely on those first 11 or 12 players to do a majority of the work.
We saw it last year in the NASL when the Armada had a number of matches Sunday, Wednesday, Saturday kind of turnarounds. And playing with a shorter roster than most NASL teams last year, the Armada really able to handle it well. Mark Lowry, the head coach, has to get kudos for the way he handled playing a little bit shorthanded. This year, somewhat of the same situation, a little bit limited with in terms of the experience on the bench. Again, we mentioned some young players are available. Mikey Melvin, just 21, able to be utilized on the bench. But most of the experience that's ready to come in, most it's college experience rather than pro experience right now for the Armada.
Yeah, that's a huge jump in, you know, not necessarily talent, but experience and just guile on the field. You know, you have a 21, 22-year-old, you know, young man playing against a 30-year-old seasoned professional who's played, you know, in Yuma's case for 10 or 12 years at the professional level, and just, you know, and it's a different experience.
Now, Yuma, guy who's played in La Liga, maybe facing up against a guy who biggest matchup was against Florida International.
Exactly. Biggest rivalry game was right here in Hodges.
All the way through, here's Gebhardt trying to make the run. He was taken out. That could be a red card as the last option. Will it be a card at all? Or will Arnell Selman keep the card in the pocket?
It should be a yellow. The red will be pushing it because there were two defenders there, one to cover, but it should definitely be a booking. But good run from Gebhardt, who cut back in from the inside and ran through that center forward channel. Good movement from Kilduff to create that negative space when he checked back towards the ball, and great pass to find him. And that's where Gebhardt's pace just starts to scare defenders.
It does not appear that the referee is going to the pocket at this point. It This ball would certainly fall into the range of the Jerome zone. We've seen Meshack Jerome score from about this spot before on free kicks.
I don't pity the guy standing in the wall right now.
Oxenette Peterson, the goalkeeper for Miami United, certainly will be aware of his fellow countrymen's prowess on the free kick and the power he can put behind this.
He's probably saved a couple of them in training with the Haitian national team.
Five, six, seven Miami United players now in the wall right now. And a couple close by. Meshack Jerome. Blast one along the ground. Peterson got down to it and able to cover it. A low screamer from Meshack Jerome, covered well by Peterson for Miami United.
Yeah, very clean strike from Jerome, and well done from Peterson to hold it, you know, and not give up a rebound, you know, because the Armada had players crashing in to clean it up, and even though he didn't catch it cleanly, he took enough sting off of it where he could just reach out and grab it. But a great strike from Jerome on the free kick.
Yuma went for a sliding play there. Couldn't get his boot to it. But it'll be a throw-in for the Armada nonetheless. 25 minutes in at Hodges Stadium. The Armada and Miami United 0-0. Coming off the 7-0 win for the Armada against Boca Raton, club president Nathan Walter said, "We've been waiting for this result." Well, now, any kind of positive result here for the Armada would be big, as they're playing for the top spot in the division. And as you mentioned, Ryan, with games in hand, the Armada control their playoff destiny at this point. And controlling your playoff destiny is great, but winning when you have that situation is what really makes it happen. Castellanos on the charge, and
Goal kick here.
Oh, I thought for a moment he was pointing to the spot.
Yeah, the referee tried to confuse us all, running towards the penalty spot with his arm out. But a great tackle from the Miami United defender to deny Castellanos after a good run early from the midfield. But that's better from the Armada, trying to play a little bit more direct and play earlier and exploit those gaps on the flanks. But like we said, I'd like to see the Armada try to combine more once they have established possession and they're attacking third of the field, and not just rely on taking what they give you and just serving a ball, hopeful ball into the box instead of trying to combine and allow your runners to get in.
Ball chipped over the top for Miami United. And played out. Granito making a move to it. It'll be a throw in for Jacksonville. U.S. Open Cup run for Miami United this year started with a win over FC Kendall, 5-2 in the first round. This is a club that's had some big scoring games. They beat Storm FC 9-0 back in May. And this one on goal, saved by Brian Holt.
Strong right paw from Holt.
Banks able to get back to it, but no, they're going to say corner kick.
But again, the Miami United did a good job of getting that initial ball in behind the winger into the left center back and got a little look at goal and a good shot and a better save.
Maximiliano Schoenfeld, the Chilean, will handle the corner kick duties here for Miami United. Outswinger. Headed away. Kilduff was in there. Schoenfeld again. Marked by J.C. Banks, and then cleared out by Meshack Jerome. The power that Jerome can generate from less than ideal footing and positions is pretty remarkable.
Yeah, it's all about the technique. But he definitely can generate power, distance, length, swerve on just about any ball that is played into him.
Granita will play it back. Long ball over the top, trying to get it to Tejera. And that results in a Jacksonville goal kick. Both sides have had some moments here in the opening half hour.
Go ahead.
Best chances probably to Jacksonville, but moment ago, Miami United with their strongest opportunity.
Yeah, they've swapped pretty good chances. I wouldn't call either, any of them clear-cut, but swapped opportunities, and the goalkeepers have come up big.
Here's Doyle on it. Gebhardt was making the overlapping run. Doyle kept it, got it back. Mentioned after beating FC Kendall in the U.S. Open Cup, Miami United beat Miami FC 3-1 before the clean sheet against the Armada 2-0. Then in the next round, lost to Orlando City 3-0. McInerney whistled for the foul. So certainly a strong season for Miami United. And they are a club that you would expect would be one of the teams to watch when the playoffs arrive, but still need to take care of some business here in the NPSL regular season. Same situation for the Armada. Ball played in, and McCauley sent one wide again. He's able to get a couple of opportunities right in front of Holt.
Yeah, got a good run at the ball. Good ball served in, you know, to a spot where Holt can't come and get it, and McCauley just got inside of his mark and generated a lot of power with the header, just couldn't get it on frame.
Holt talking to his defenders, wanting little stronger checking on those balls into the box.
Yeah, he got free way too easily. You know, you got to mark the center forward. Rule number one on set pieces. It's the reason why he's the number nine.
Now Jerome. Given some space. Tried to get it to Kilduff. Now headed ahead by Silva. Kilduff. Castellanos making a run down the middle. Beg your pardon, that was Connor Doyle making the run down the middle. He'll like to have that one back.
I'd like to see a little bit more from J.C. Banks on this right flank. He's getting pinned back a little bit by his opposite number, opposite winger, you know, number three, Shinfield. But I'd like to see a little bit more because he's one of those creative driving forces that if he's good, the Armada is going to have a good chance to be successful.
Now a giveaway, and Kilduff tried to slot one over to Castellanos but couldn't get it there, and you could see his frustration. Just one touch eluding the Armada right now, it feels like, from finding their way to a goal.
Yeah, that final pass, final touch has been a step off. I think Kilduff there was trying to play the ball to himself instead of playing Castellanos in, and defenders did a good job to read it.
It'll be an Armada throw in. Quickly into Silva. He's closed down in a hurry. Miami United the takeaway. Trying to get it ahead to McCauley. And chipped all the way across. Headed away by Wes Sharpie.
That's the second or third time that Silva's been caught in possession in transition. You know, needs to do a better job of picking his head up early and finding that option because he needs to play simply in that transitional phase of the game and not try to create too much or hold on to the ball too much. Or he's going to continue to lose it. And he's been losing it in dangerous positions.
Silva, a veteran, has played in the USL, has played in Sweden as well, former University of Tampa and USF star. At 28, he's a guy who has played some pro soccer. And most of these guys out there for the Armada in terms of the starting 11 have good experience. You have some younger players, certainly. Even a younger player like Gebhardt has plenty of playing experience, getting a lot of it here the last couple of years. Corner kick for Miami United. Sent in, Kilduff got in the way. Meshack Jerome will track it down for Jacksonville and clear it out.
Great pace on the serve from Shinfield, from that left side.
And then a great job by Gebhardt to force the action there. And Tejera had to come over, and all he could do was play it out because Gebhardt made the run from all the way across the field.
Yeah, good selfless running from Gebhardt to keep that play alive and not allow Miami United to keep the ball and transition back into the attack, either off the throw-in or off the run of play.
Sharpie will track back to it for Jacksonville.
Talked about the interchange, the fluidity of the Armada. Now Gebhardt is starting. He's played a little closer to Kilduff his last 7 or 8 minutes. You know, almost as in a two-front. You know, now he'll drift wide and Castellanos will come in. You know, lots of fluidity, but just need, like you said, the final pass is lacking a little bit. Need to be a little bit better in that entry pass, that final decision.
And Castellanos has come underneath Kilduff. Banks pushing forward, as you suggested. Now Kilduff coming all the way back in the Armada end for it. Now Jerome. Look at this precision pass all the way across the field. Gebhard. He's got Sharpie overlapping. Tried to slot it through for Castellanos. Turned away by the Miami United defense. Now out wide.
Good recovery.
Schoenfeld from distance. Got a lot on it, but it swerved away from the goal.
Good save by Squid Vicious.
got a tentacle on it.
Yes. But again, that's, you know, Gebhardt's final decision there. He probably should have at least tried to fake the overlap and read the defender to, you know, as the overlap came, but he tried to cut inside and his last touch let him down, and it led to a quick counter, which can happen when you're playing with the two systems that they are, with the three in the back.
Gebhard tried to wait for it. It was cut off by Miami United. Here is United. Silva, nice job defending there to get a toe to it. And it can bring a counter opportunity for Jacksonville. Here's Gebhard. Does not turn on the jets here. Said waits for Yuma. Now Connor Doyle playing it out wide for J.C. Banks. This is how the Armada want to play. Banks cuts it inside. A little heavy on the touch there. But Silva in just the right spot. Doyle, though, was caught offside as he came back for it. So a promising build-up for the Armada turns to naught.
Yeah, it's just that like we've talked about, that last decision. You know, Banks' heavy touch allowed the move to break down, and Doyle's timing was off from the run. He wanted the ball early, and the heavy touch didn't allow it, and unfortunately got caught offside. But it's just that one little final entry pass, final decision, final dribble that just needs to improve. You know, after Gebhardt's bright start, he's sort of slowed down a little bit. You know, Miami United has made some good adjustments and sat back and played off of him and let him run to him instead of trying to mark him tight.
Now a long ball will be handled by Holt.
So when Yuma comes deep to get the ball, there needs to be somebody coming in behind him to fill a space, you know, so there's not just a huge, huge hole in the midfield.
At the moment, Silva filled that role. Now here's Doyle coming back for it for Jacksonville.
Silva did come fill the role, but I think it needs to be a little bit quicker. You know, it's just so Yuma can turn. And
Jerome plays it back under some duress. Now Holt will chip one forward for Banks. Little flick on header. Kept in by Miami United. Nope, it was not. Throw in for Jacksonville.
But that, you know, that could be the fatigue and just the playing conditions. You know, trying to save legs, trying to move, you know, 8 minutes ago until the half, you know, but still that interchange needs to be, it's fluid, but it's not fast at times. You know, when it's fast and quick, you're going to be able to play in and play out and, you know, really confuse and really draw the defending teams out, but just a bit slow.
I was going to say, part of that certainly has to be attributed to the weather, to the heat.
No, I'm not discounting that at all. It's just, you know, you talk about, you have seasoned pros on the field. They know that they should probably do that. And I'm sure that Lowry will have a chat with them. You know, if it's not tonight, it will be after film breakdown, things like that. But the interchange is there. The rotation is there. It just needs to be faster.
Silva tried to step in front of that one. Miami United able to keep possession. Now David Santa Maria Jr. lost it. Now here's Doyle playing it ahead for Kilduff. Gebhard making the run on the far side. Hilduff couldn't maintain possession.
Just slightly behind him.
Just a half a tick off right now in terms of the Armada on the attack. Coming off a 7-goal performance, it has to be a bit frustrating to see these opportunities go by the wayside.
Yeah, the thing is, you just got to keep plugging, keep digging. You know, forwards' memories have to be super short. Wingers' memories have to be super short, so they can't dwell on the mistakes they've made. So make sure that they're nice and confident for the next attempt, which is, like you said, coming off a 7-goal game, everybody on the field should be pretty confident in their finishing ability.
Here's Silva, grabbed and just flat-out taken down. No card on that one, but that was...
That was rugby style.
That could have been not just a booking, it could have been a charge from campus police.
Put him in the sin bin.
Here comes Miami United. They've been dangerous in moments in this first half.
And the Armada now for the last 4 or 5 minutes have struggled to connect, you know, more than about two or three passes in a row. You know, the movement, like I said, the movement's been a bit slow.
And Jerome there to clear it out after McCauley tried to tee one up. Two Miami United players come together.
That's their excuse for not wanting to head that bomb.
With Kilduff in the neighborhood. And now stoppage in play for the moment. That's Tahera. Gets the hand up from Arnell Selman, the referee.
Yeah, about the last 3 or 4 minutes is just the Armada have gotten, just haven't been as sharp and as crisp as they need to be with the ball. You know, they haven't been able to get out of their own half because they're not building. You know, Kilduff's touch has let him down a couple of times. The ball's played into him haven't been great, but, you know, still you would expect him to be able to, a player of his quality, to be able to deal with it a little bit better. But just they need to get back. The Armada needs to get back to possessing and thinking 2 steps ahead.
Here's Castellanos on the run. His run got interrupted.
Good tackle from Pierre there.
And both sides have been a bit inaccurate here in the last several minutes in terms of placement of the ball.
It's got a little sloppy. But unfortunately for the Armada, it's Miami's been less sloppy and then been able to keep the Armada pinned into their own half.
Holt goes the short way to meet Shaq Jerome. Now to Shane McInerney.
This is better.
Here's Sharpie. Now to Silva in the middle.
Kilduff came deep and nobody went to occupy the center backs.
Tried to get it to Gebhardt again. And again, one pass eludes the Armada.
I think the chat that Lowry will have with the boys at halftime will be just do the simple things better. Do them quicker. You know, because that's really where the moves are breaking down. It's not breaking down because Miami United is defending just so well. It's just we're the Armada are the makers of their own fate, you know, so to say. They need to be a little more precise and be more consistent and just, you know, just clean it up. That's what I would tell my players. I would just tell them to clean it up. It needs to be better.
Another errant pass gives Miami United the opportunity for a counter. Sharpie, who had overlapped, has to come all the way back. Meshack Jerome finds himself right in the right spot to head this one away for the moment. Banks trying to check on Fernando Hernandez. Again, Meshack able to redirect with his head. And now just clears it out toward midfield.
The big thing now is not for either team to concede before the half. You know, I think both teams will go into the halftime of the locker room and say, hey, that last 10 minutes wasn't sharp enough. We both need to be better. You know, and just the worst thing that could happen for either team now would be to concede a goal.
Jerome defending and able to harass enough. The ball to come free for Wes Sharpie. Now here is Gebhardt. One touch from Kilduff to Yuma. Castellanos, a long run for this one. He's got some help in the box right now. Miami United starting to track back. Castellanos, who played his college soccer right here on this pitch at UNF.
All the players have run forward, and there's no Armada presence around the referee. When you know, when I've coached young players, I've almost told them you always have to have somebody near the referee because he's normally the second pass. He's normally one pass away if he's in a good position. That's a little coaching tip for young kids that are listening today, watching today.
Long one over the top. Kilduff can't get there. Doyle tried to step in front of it. Yuma will come do it for Jacksonville. The Armada, a long string of possession here, but it hasn't been very dangerous, at least not yet.
This is better, though. They've gotten up, and they've connected a couple passes and able to pin Miami United back.
Jerome toward the penalty spot. Peterson able to come out and get it before Kilduff could get there. And you can see from Kilduff's body language, kind of equal parts fatigue and maybe a little disgust, frustration.
To Jerome's credit, he put his hands up immediately when he hit it and apologized for the lack of quality in the service. One thing with this shape, how the Armada is a little unbalanced. Gebhardt is pushing high up the field, and it's almost forcing Banks into a pseudo right back role, and it just unbalances the field. And when they want to change the field, either Banks is already run early to get into that back line, or he's so deep that he has to run from late and he's going to get picked up a little easier.
Gebhardt playing all the way back defending here. We're coming to the end of regulation time here. 2 minutes of stoppage time going to be added at the end of this half. Gebhardt maintains possession, and now the foul. Sharpie had a piece taken out of him.
Yeah, more clumsy than intentional on that one.
We are into stoppage time here in the first half. Nil-nil, there have been a couple of opportunities for each side. You wouldn't say any of them have been golden opportunities, but they've been, for the most part, for the Armada, good build-up chances that weren't finalized. And for Miami United, a couple of shots that, if taken slightly cleaner, may have been more of a challenge for Brian Holt.
You can definitely tell they're trying to play on the break.
Here's the counter now again for Miami United. Right down the middle of the park. Play it out wide. This is Gordon on the run. Beg your pardon, Schoenfeld again. Having a hard time seeing those gold numbers against the white jerseys.
Definitely not easy for us. But the chances that Miami United have had are teams that are very typical of a team that plays on the counter. You know, almost half chances, snapshots, things like that. And the Armada's chances have come from a team that wants to dominate in ball possession, you know, from crosses from deep or from near the end line, not deep. And, you know, but like we said, I'd like to see more combination play around the box to get numbers around. But their chances have come from, you know, ball serve from near the end line as in to the opposite way that the Miami United have, or shots from outside the box centrally.
Castellanos. Now Doyle. And back to Meshack Jerome. Final half minute of stoppage time here. Jerome looking for Kilduff. Tried to head one to a sprinting Doyle who was closing down. Another good opportunity, just a fraction of an inch away from connecting.
It was well defended from Miami United, but you could see that's something that little last sequence was something that the Armada have definitely worked on. Kilduff pulling to the back post. And Jerome trying to serve that diagonal ball into a runner.
Halftime is here. 0-0 between Jacksonville and Miami United. The Armada looking to beat Miami United for the first time here in 2018. And they'll need to find a goal in the second half to do so. We'll have the second half for you after this.
Don't forget to stop by the Guest Services or Leaf Hole area. John Von Braun, Dr. Kamal Basali, and Alex Witter, certified athletic trainer, are providing the medical services for today's Armada game from the Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute, where the pros go. Stop by the JOI table on the main concourse for more information, free giveaways, and enter to win a team-signed mini ball. On Beach Boulevard to watch the 2018 FIFA World Cup matches. Every Thursday is karaoke night, and every Friday night we have live music with drink specials and delicious Colombian food.
Thank you.
Section 904, the loudest and the proudest supporters group of the Jacksonville Armada FC. A large group of people with different backgrounds that all possess one passion, supporting our local team. Everyone is welcome to come and stand and sing with us in our designated section. Help us create a very unique culture in Jacksonville. A soccer culture that creates a fun and exciting atmosphere supporting our great city and our team. Head over to section904.com or facebook.com/section904 for membership information.
Bye.
Armada substitution. Coming in is number 15, Portilla, for number 8, Silva.
Ready to start the second half here in Jacksonville. The Armada and Miami United 0-0 after 45 minutes. The Armada have made a change at halftime. Camilo Portilla, the young Colombian, is on in place of Christian Silva. And as you were pointing out, Ryan, maybe wanting to get a little more suddenness out of that position. And right now, Portilla, who we've seen both as an attacking mid as well as a holding mid, playing fairly far forward. He and Castellanos right now are playing in behind Kieran Kilduff, while Gebhardt has dropped a little deeper here for Jacksonville.
Yeah, Portillo brings a little bit of guile, a little bit of creativity for that final pass that the Armada struggled with in the first half. You know, look to see him get on the ball in the last third of the field, see if they can make a difference.
Here's Castellanos trying to get past the defender. He's got Kilduff in front. And tried to slot it through for Portilla, who was coming in. Intercepted by Miami United, though. Portilla, 19 years old from Colombia, did play for the Colombian U17 squad. That's a pretty good bit of pedigree. And also played in the Colombian second division as a teenager.
Yeah, I just looked for him to get on the ball and try to unlock the defense in that final pass of Miami United. You know, almost looks like the Armada have gone to a back four.
And Banks has settled way back in. Part of that may be because Schoenfeld continues to press forward for Miami United.
Yeah, Schoenfeld's kept him pinned back, but if they have changed, it's a natural change that suits the personnel on the field. You know, allows Yuma to do what he does and sort of frees up players in the middle.
Tried to send one over the top. Santa Maria was in the area, but it was defended well by Jacksonville.
You know, they did go to a 4-1-4, and that's a system that they started the year playing in, and something they're very comfortable in. And I think it will help in the transitional build-ups in the wide areas, because you're not asking one player to cover the distance that they're used to two doing more and more, you know, because they've played for a majority of the year, at least for the first part of the year, in this 4-3-3 with wide midfielders or wingers. And, you know, you have double coverage on those wings with the outside backs getting forward as well.
Yeah, Yuma really settling into a number six role right now, so it may be sort of an abridged 4-1-4-1 for the Armada at this moment. Now Miami United on the buildup. McInerney able to boot it away. And right now you see McInerney and Meshack Jerome really playing more as traditional center backs. As you mentioned, you see Banks number 10 there in the upper right of your screen, settling back into almost a right back role. Into the box. Banks and Meshack combining there. And this one will be a goal kick for Jacksonville.
Yeah, I just think if this is the shape they've gone with Sharpie at the left back, I think it's just going to be a little more natural balance to how they want to play and not have to rely on Banks and Gebhardt covering, you know, all 120 yards of the flanks all the time. But still, with the shape, it does allow Banks to get forward, which he naturally loves to do.
There's the Colombian teenager, Portilla, taken down, grabbed his knee, slow to get up. The Armada maintained possession here. Now Portilla up, a little slow, a little hobbled.
That's a tough challenge. But up and moving again.
McInerney coming forward.
The system also gives you a little more balance and width. You know, it's going to force that back three to spread out and almost go 1v1.
Keeping an eye on Portilla. He still does not look like he's completely recovered from that. Now ahead. Here's Banks coming forward from that right wing, right back position. Can't get through the white shirts. Jerome came up, committed a professional foul there. Able to slow things up and give Banks time to track back.
But what can happen is is Gebhardt and Castellanos gets pinned back and be thrown back four into a back six, which can happen against the shape that Miami's in with, you know, almost at times five front players. So you have to trust, Gebhardt's going to have to trust that Sharpie can cover the winger behind him and sort of push forward a little bit more to be a little more proactive.
Offside flag stays down, but this ball can be tracked down near the corner flag.
For goal.
But it'll be a goal kick now for Jacksonville. Now, Miami United has come out a little more aggressively than they did at the outset of the match.
Yeah, they sort of nicked the balance of the play for the last, you know, 15 minutes or so of the first half, and they've started back on the front foot. You know, Armada needs to get back to keeping the ball.
Another turnover by the Armada. McInerney got a foot to that one. And then Portilla ranging back. And finally, Miami United whistled for the foul.
We got a little pull on Portilla there.
Number of Armada players now at the top of your screen heading over to start loosening up here just in case. The only ones remaining on the bench. Silva, who's been subbed off already, and Alexander Gojic, who is the backup goalkeeper, not likely to be called on unless there's an emergency.
Or an outbreak of seven goals. They did get, what, the last 10 minutes in the last game.
Here's Jerome looking for a long one again. Sends one over the top. Castellanos chasing after it. Now Kilduff. Kieran Kilduff plays it back for J.C. Banks. The Armada trying to set something up here. Portilla. Connor Doyle out wide now for Banks. Nice little side foot for Portilla. The young Colombian working for it. Now Banks sends it in. Headed away. Gebhardt will allow this one to trickle out.
That's better for the Armada. In the first half, Banks would have been isolated on the wing without support on the right or left, and he would have been forced to play the service, maybe the same ball, but he had...
Now Connor Doyle, from a spot he likes, he scored from about that area a couple of times this year, but... Hit the ball on the rise, and off it went. And a substitution coming up now for Miami United. Victor Pelé coming on, and he will replace David Santamaria. Pelé scored a hat trick last time out for Miami United.
Yeah, very, not shocked, but very interesting decision to start him on the bench coming off a hat trick.
Brazilian.
Miami United FC substitution coming in is number 9, coming out is number 11.
And Santa Maria sits down, so we'll see how quickly Pelé gets himself involved in the attack. We'll be setting up over on the right side as a forward. And there he is. Ball at his chest, marked by Wes Sharpie.
Looks to be very similarly built to Kilduff. Big, tall, rangy, strong player.
25-year-old Brazilian. This one played over the top. Bouncing to McCauley. Now Pelé dispossessed by Yuma. Now the Armada on the counter. Here's Portilla. With Gebhardt right behind him.
Near an out ball.
The Armada just trying to find that fine-tuning of the attack that has eluded them so far today. They've had some moments.
All credit to Miami United. They've been very compact and very organized in the back and in transition and recovery. You know, part of that is the Armada's patient buildup, like we talked about in the first half. Maybe go a little more direct or don't have to serve it long and bypass the middles. But, you know, Jerome there had a chance a couple seconds ago to play forward, and he played back the goalkeeper, which allows Miami to get organized. You know, he's skillful enough, and there's no pressure on his right to play out.
All over the top for Kilduff, who's on the run. Gebhardt coming in support as well into the box. Kilduff will play it back to J.C. Banks. Now Doyle in, and Portilla, not sure if it was his head or a Miami United head that made contact with the ball, but Peterson able to handle it for Miami United. Into the midfield, and headed back by McInerney. I'll allow Holt to play with his hands if he wishes. Instead, he'll send it along the ground to Meshack Jerome. First 10 minutes of this second half, you'd have to say Miami United has been slightly more on the ball. The Armada have had some moments as well.
It looks like Miami has, at times, changed shape to match the Armada.
It really feels like one of those matches that's going to be 1-0 based on who makes the mistake.
Yeah, absolutely. It's what the game definitely has that feeling. And I think the Armada, from a quality standpoint, is a little more dangerous in the final third. Just can they find that entry pass? Can they find that final ball or force that mistake of Miami United?
Here's Jerome again.
Good ball.
Here's Portilla. He's got Gebhardt on his left. Derek Gebhardt now. Waiting for reinforcements to come. Splits the defense. Gebhardt to the end line. Tried to cut it back. Defended well by Pierre. It'll be a corner kick for Jacksonville, but Gebhardt, who usually likes to go wide, cut it back to the inside that time.
Yeah, he saw the double team and saw that the double team was coming, and it was flat. There was no cover in the double. And just a little chip over this tackle and use his pace to get the inline. But that's much better. We need to see more of that from the Armada.
Shelton Shamar coming in. He'll replace Fernando Hernandez. Shamar was the player who scored the equalizing goal in the last match between these two sides down in South Florida.
On paper, that's a midfielder for a defender. Will you see a change of mentality or change of shape for Miami United?
Corner kick, Jacksonville. Doyle got it to Kilduff, who got ahead to it.
Good defending from United to force another corner. If he doesn't jump cleanly with Kilduff, he could force the goalkeeper into a save.
Now Doyle will make the march from corner on this side to the far side.
It's about 80 yards.
Just a little stroll in the park. Castellanos also going over that way. So Castellanos will take it from the far corner.
So here you have a 2-1. Will they try to exploit it as they send Miami recognize and send a second defender? Or not?
Doyle didn't connect with a teammate. Cleared out by Miami United for the moment.
I like the idea on the set piece. Change the angle. You know, hit a flatter service. You can hit a flatter service from a moving ball than you can a stationary ball. Just slightly over the top of Kilduff's head.
We've seen the Armada on a couple of occasions try to change things up, change that approach angle, as you say, on these set pieces. Trying to keep things fresh and adding new wrinkles here as the season goes on. Long ball, Kilduff. A header to Gebhardt. Portilla on the overlap.
Good patience. This is better.
Portilla. Back for Sharpie. You see the wide width for the Armada right now. Sharpie all the way on the touchline. Castellanos. A little push. That time. Pelé got a piece of him. Free kick, Jacksonville.
I'd like to see more from the Armada. Oh.
And now Dominguez got right up in Yuma's face. Yuma gave him a little shove, and Dominguez looks like he was shot from a sniper in the balcony. We saw plenty of this the last time these two sides met in Jacksonville at JU during the U.S. Open Cup. Dominguez and Yuma really went at it of the match.
Yeah, a little history with those two, especially from the Open Cup match. But going back to that last possession, you know, Armada did good patience in the width and kept the ball with Gebhardt, with Portillo and Doyle and such, and Yuma. But we just need to see more movement from the front runners. The players got to the top of the box, and they stood and they waited. I'd like to see them move and interchange a little bit more.
Doyle on a little 1-2 from Yuma. One header, and then a second by Banks. Kilduff was able to redirect it. Banks got his head to it, but he was warding off a defender as he did. And a goal kick coming for Miami United as we near the hour mark here in Jacksonville in this battle for the top spot in the NPSL Sunshine Division. An Armada win today puts them alone atop the division in terms of points per game. Right now they're tied with Miami FC and just ahead of Miami United. Now Gebhardt, a draw. Miami FC is the top team. A Miami United win, and they're on top of the division. So three different outcomes could result in three different looks at the top of the table. Jerome along the ground for Kilduff. Doyle changing fields for Gebhardt. He's got Portilla with him. Got some pace with Portilla and Gebhardt on that side.
Yeah, Portilla's been good since he came on at halftime. You know, he's driven at the back line from deeper positions and forced Miami United to come out and defend him a little bit more, which will create more space for the forwards to run.
Here's Portilla coming deep for it. Now Doyle. Doyle's done a lot of running in this one.
He's earned his chocolate milk for post-match.
Portilla now on the other side of the pitch. Across for Yuma, who's coming on the attack. Now Gebhardt. Gebhardt to the byline. Kicked out in front. And a misfire by the Armada. Oh, what an opportunity there. I think it was Castellanos who got his left foot to it and just over-torqued it just a bit.
Yeah, he got more ankle than foot on it. But good work from Gebhardt. Good movement from Yuma to come and get the ball from deep. Good ball from the right wing into Yuma, who then found the isolation. Gebhardt on the width. But that's better. That's, you know, you've added numbers. You added width to the attack. And the ball was vertical, and it was direct, and Gebhardt did a good job. I think he's got his right back's number, but just too much ankle bone, not enough foot from the Armada number 7.
Now, one other thing we saw different there was Yuma coming forward quite a bit further.
Yeah, but that was part of the rotation. Players had rotated through. Miami FC had no players in the back line, so Yuma could go forward because he didn't have to protect anybody. You know, the center backs were there, pushed him forward, and, you know, he showed his experience and his, you know, his passing ability there to recognize the 2v1 for Gebhardt.
A terrific awareness by Yuma, as you would expect for a veteran of his caliber. And there he is on the ball. Well done by Yuma, with Doyle and Yuma back there, guys who have seen a lot of soccer through the years.
It's a lot of professional games between those two.
Here's Gebhardt. Portilla comes behind him. Tried to get it to Sharpie, who came forward as well. Things got crowded over there for the Armada. And a turnover for Jacksonville into Miami. McInerney.
Good tackle.
Bit risky, and it turned out to be the right call. If he doesn't get to that one, it's just Meshack Jerome back with a couple of Miami United attackers. Shamar has set up in a forward position as well. So right now you've got McCauley with Pelé and Shamar on either side of him.
Yeah, they've gone to a three front. Almost a 3-4-3.
Last time these two sides hooked up, a 1-1 draw in Hialeah. Feeling more and more like one would be enough to get the 3 points here.
Yeah, the Armada have shown to be a bit more dangerous, especially on the set-piece side. You know, good chances from corners, good chances from free kicks. The save in the first half that Peterson had on the Jerome free kick, I think that could be the difference today.
Kilduff wins a throw-in for Jacksonville.
It's another guy who's done a lot of selfless running today and been isolated for long periods of time up front. You know, he's a willing runner, works very, very hard. You know, he's gonna want more support underneath the ball, and the ball gets into him, though. That's going to be key for the Armada to be able to generate and keep pressure in the final third.
Here's Doyle with Jerome coming forward now. The Armada dedicating a lot to the attack here in the 65th minute. Here's Banks. Sends one into the box. Kilduff able to track it down, and the chip saved off the line by Miami United. Terrific defending by Miami United there. Kilduff with a nice bit of skill and almost gave the Armada the lead.
That would have been candidate for goal of the year for sure. Kilduff, great first touch to bring the ball down and to twist around and recognize the goalkeeper off his line and try to loop it over him. But again, great defending, like you said, for Miami United to give Peterson some cover and head the ball off the line.
I think it was Pierre that got his head to it, who's been playing with a yellow card since the seventh minute.
Yeah, he's definitely done well after a slow start.
Now Connor Doyle to handle the corner kick for Jacksonville. Headed once and cleared out. McInerney was in there.
Great corner. Like I said, set pieces could be the difference. Armada definitely should have had a chance, made the goalkeeper work on that one.
Here's Sharpie. He'll swing one into the box, headed away by the Miami United defense. And it'll be a throw in for Jacksonville. Another Miami substitution coming up. Batista Dominguez coming out. And I wish I could tell you the number. Can't see it from over here. Appears to be Ignacio Cubeto.
Substitution coming on the field is number 21 for number 18.
Ignacio Cubeto. 32-year-old Italian, so a veteran coming on for Miami United. Here's Sharpie. Portilla. Sharpie coming through. Nicely done by Portilla. Crossed in, but over the top of Kilduff. Still free in the box. Doyle coming forward to try to track it down. Jerome a header to keep it back in. Feels like the Armada sensing an opportunity there. No whistle on Yuma. Now Banks. And now a whistle to slow things down.
Ball went out, I think. But yeah, the Armada definitely have their tails up. Sense a little weakness. They've probed for weakness and found it in Miami United. You know, basically through the flank play.
McCauley is the Miami United player who was down a moment ago. He's a little slow getting up.
Yeah, he took quite a hit from Yuma. I don't think there's much malice in it, but you know, you're almost 70 minutes into this game, and McCauley's been a lot like Kilduff, done a lot of selfless running, and you know, little hits like that start to add up when you're fatigued.
So the question is, free kick here, or?
I think it's a throw-in.
Throw-in. It is. Jack Jerome, an overhead kick to clear it out for Jacksonville. Another one of those awkward stances with remarkable power from Meshack.
That's just pure athletic ability. That's all that is.
Holt coming off his line. Able to run out in front of it and cover it up for Jacksonville. McCauley made another run at it. And a little bit of a pitter-patter moment for the goalkeeper's heart, perhaps. Kilduff gets pushed down. No whistle there. Right now, Arnell Selman, the referee, letting him play a bit.
I think he's done a good job today.
I would agree.
Been pretty transparent, which is what you asked for in a referee. Cards early, I think, dictated the energy and sort of took some of the sharpness out of it, which is not a bad thing in a game that can be seen as a rivalry. Well done from Portillo.
Portillo on the run, now gets it to Castellanos. Joshua Castellanos will play it back for J.C. Banks. The Armada now coming forward in the 70th minute. Here's Yuma. Portillo plays it back to the Spaniard. Doyle looking for Kilduff. A header. Portillo running for it and was cut off by the defense, bodied up as Oxenham-Peterson came out and was able to grab it. A little bit of contact, but I think it was more Peterson making contact with his own player who was warding off Portilla's run.
But again, that high ball into Kilduff and the runner off is dangerous. Just have to connect with it.
You like the shape change by the Armada here in the second half?
Yeah, they've been a little more positive. The natural width has helped them. You know, looking at this now, Miami FC is going to do a 4-2-3-1 to counter it. So now it's back to a man-on-man and win your battle. But I think the shape change has helped with the width and the support in the wide channels.
Here's Pelé. Hat-trick score, last game out for Miami United. Weaving his way through, played it out wide. Now sent all the way through the box. And Gebhardt will track it down for Jacksonville. An Armada substitution coming up soon. Mikey Melvin, I believe, is going to come in for Banks and give the Armada a true four-back look, if I saw the substitution board correctly. And that's indeed the move. Second sub for the Armada.
Armada substitution coming onto the field is number 3, Melvin. Coming out, number 10, J.C. Banks.
We've seen Melvin play left back position more often than not. And that's where he heads. So that means Sharpie will probably come over to the right.
Now you can add natural width in the outside back position. On both sides, not just one.
So true four defenders out there right now for Jacksonville with Melvin, McInerney, Meshack Jerome, and Sharpie. Though Sharpie certainly has the ability to go forward. Melvin has shown that a bit as well. Melvin will set up on the right. And actually, at this point, Sharpie, setting up on the right, is actually playing a more forward position.
That's
almost replacing Banks' spot.
That's a natural shape in this system in the 4-1-4-1, especially with Yuma being as smart and as experienced as he is to drop in and give cover when needed. It allows both outside backs to go.
Now Portillo with Gebhardt to his left. Camilo Portillo got some space. Save made by Peterson. What a performance Peterson has turned in this year against Jacksonville. He made a game-saving stop there.
Yeah, great one-on-one play from Portillo to cut inside and create a shot. I think he just caught it a little bit fat, as they would say in the golf world, and just didn't get all of it. You know, but not to take anything away from the save from Peterson, you know, down into his left. Good strong paw to push it out for a corner.
Another corner opportunity for Jacksonville.
I still think this is Armada's best chance to find one.
On a set piece.
Yes, sir.
Doyle standing over there waiting for it. They tee him up. Doyle swings one in. Header. And the second ball in. It was McInerney first and then Gebhardt, who almost made you prophetic.
Yeah. I don't think it would have counted. I think it was a bit offside. But again, changed the angle of the service. But I think that's where it's going to come from is from a set piece today, because they're just so – they're better at attacking them than Miami United is at defending them.
Now the question, how many more set pieces will the Armada find in the next 16 minutes plus?
Yes, every time the ball goes out of bounds, it's going to be a walk to it for Miami United. Goal kicks, change sides, ask for a new ball. They'll say, I'll take a point on the road.
Remember, both these teams in good position for the playoffs. The top three in the division make the postseason. Melvin getting his first defensive action, able to send one out.
Good tackle. Had to go to ground, but it was a good, strong tackle.
And this one stays in. Gebhard will bring it forward for Jacksonville. Gebhard looking for some space. It'll be a throw in for the Armada. Again, a win for Jacksonville. They're atop the division at the end of the day. A win for Miami United. They're atop the division at the end of the day. A draw, and it's Miami FC who will be the top of the table in the Sunshine Division. Again, top three in the division will make it to the postseason. We anticipate these two teams in Miami FC to be the three from the state of Florida to make it into the NPSL playoffs. It's really all a question about seeding, and the seeding all important, as we mentioned.
Yeah, you definitely want to finish first.
Get a little extra break.
And a home game.
And a home match. Now Miami United trying to create something.
Good skill.
Castellanos, the takeaway. Leaves it off for Portilla. The Armada with numbers here. Gebhard racing up the wing. Into the box. Derek Gebhard looking for some space. And this will be a corner kick for Jacksonville.
Good fast break. Good skill from Castellanos to spring the break. And good decision from Gebhard, I think, to try to take the player on and cut in and create a shot. But again, another corner, another opportunity for the Armada on a set piece.
There's an Armada player down near the penalty spot. It's Castellanos, who's done a lot of running today. He is just bathed in sweat right now. McInerney again comes forward, put his big body in there with Kilduff. Here's Connor Doyle. And Peterson off his line to grab it right in front of Kilduff, trying to trigger a quick counter for Miami United. There's United on the run.
Good cover from Jerome.
Boy, he made a little, almost a shoulder fake as if he was going to go for a tackle. A little false step for the Miami United player, and then Meshack was easily back to it.
Yeah, because he knows if he touches Meshack, he's not going to win that battle. And there wouldn't be anything wrong with the tackle, but that's just body control and just experience really coming through for Meshack.
Castellanos trying to dig it out and wins a throw in for Jacksonville. 78th minute here at Hodges Stadium. Kilduff pushed down. Another chance for a set piece for Jacksonville.
Get the center backs forward. It's not in shooting range. It's going to be a service. I would probably look for it around the back post penalty spot to top of the six for two headers, I would say. A header, win the first ball and head the second one in.
It's not in shooting range unless it's Meshack, and then it's
always
maybe
in shooting range. Oh, it is.
But for now, Jerome is well back, so Yuma's lined up to take this one with Connor Doyle right there.
Yeah, look to drop that ball into the corner of the six, and you know where the goalkeeper's not comfortable coming to get it. And look for two headers, very similar to Spain's goal with Diego Costa in the World Cup last week.
Sharpie coming forward for Jacksonville. Oh, they get a little tricky. Tried to send it through for Gebhard, who couldn't quite track it down. Had a little too much pace even for Derek. And Miami United will bring it along.
Like the idea, though.
Takeaway by Yuma, who stays after it. Kilduff battling. And finally, Miami United able to clear it out. That was about as much pressure as a team that looked like they were about to go on a counter as you'll ever see.
A good counter-pressing from the Armada to win the loose ball. or to pressure the loose ball, Yuma, especially to close that outlet pass down and deflect it and make them keep chasing.
And here's Gebhardt. On the way back to McInerney.
Good forward pass.
Played out wide. Sharpie sends it. And a corner kick coming again for Jacksonville.
That is, this has been the better side for the corners from Jacksonville because they run the two-man corner to be able to play that flat service in.
50-50 raffle winner number is 237.
It's a slow walk by Connor Doyle right now over in that direction. It's been a hot, sticky, punishing night here in Jacksonville.
Looking at the roster, if the Armada was going to make their one more change.
Yuma, a header in. Kilduff. Peterson got his hands on it. The offside flag was down. And again, Oxen and Peterson is keeping Miami United alive.
Yeah, he's man of the match today so far. The first 80 minutes of the match. But again, Kilduff in the right place at the right time. He just needs to, you know, try to swing through it and almost blasted him from inside 3 yards. I like the idea of trying to flick it and juggle the goalkeeper. Sombrero, some people call it, but, you know, just turn and blast it. See what happens.
Now, a little bit of perhaps a slowdown tactic there by Shelton Shamar.
Oh, definitely.
Firing a loose ball back onto the pitch. Not that Miami United has shown that they want to play for a nil-nil at this point. I think they would be not unpleased to get away with the draw here. But they continue to try to counterattack.
Yeah, they're definitely still keeping their Armada honest. They're dangerous on the counter. They had that spell of about the last 15 minutes of the first half and the first five of the second half where they sort of dictated the pace of play. Now the Armada have settled in and, you know, forced, you're looking now, a back six for Miami United. But I think Portillo has been a huge bright spot for the Armada today in the second half.
And he threw the broadcaster's jinx on him on a giveaway, but he stays after it, and the young Colombian wins possession back for Jacksonville.
But he's been a bright spot.
Sharpie ahead to Kilduff. Little flick on. Castellanos tracks it down, tries to cut it back toward Kilduff.
Good defending.
Yeah, well defended by Miami United. I think that was Daniel Navarro who got in the way.
Yeah, Navarro got goal side of Kilduff. He didn't. That should have been 1-0. But great, great recovery. Good flick on from Kilduff and run pass from Castellanos. And, you know, did a great job to recover and defend the service.
Now Miami United trying to take advantage of a rare opportunity here in the second half. Cut back right out in front. And McInerney was not in the right position, but maybe able to muscle his way in and took the worst of it as the Jacksonville will have a goal kick.
Yeah, good flank play. Sharpie left 1v1, and the winger did a good job for Miami United to get to the end line and create that opportunity. And, you know, Sharpie did just enough to put, I think that was Mickley off on the finish.
I think it was Shelton Shamar gave a little conversation to McInerney afterwards as well. Here's Portilla. Pinwheeling in midfield. Camilo Portilla. A lot of time on the ball. Able to get it back to Mikey Melvin. Now Yuma changing fields for Meshack Jerome.
Good find.
Here's Connor Doyle. Got Sharpie making the run to his right. Instead to Castellanos. Now sent across. Back to the feet of Yuma.
Last 7 minutes, the Armada's going to have to find a way to create an opportunity from open play, you know, through some movement off the ball or a special flick like that. Just have to be aware. They've got to find a way to create.
You mentioned you thought their best chance to score was going to be on a set piece, but no guarantee that set pieces come.
Yeah, you have to dictate the play and get after them in the final third. A little more movement and interchange through the front. You know, player checks deep, player runs behind, player runs wide, player runs in. You know, to just keep the United defenders guessing.
Meshack Jerome plays it out wide. Wes Sharpie. Sharpie near the corner, trying to find some space. Now Jerome sends it all the way through. Gebhard.
Difficult ball.
Yep.
Had a little bit of pressure. I had to make sure the defender wasn't going to give him a little nudge, but difficult ball to try to cut back. I like the idea to try to cut the ball back with the first touch. But again, every time the ball goes out of bounds for Miami, in Miami's favor, it's going to be a walk restart.
Oxenden Peterson taking his time on this goal kick.
Surprised he didn't get a swig of water while he was there.
Peterson plays this one forward, headed by Mikey Melvin to Yuma. Now Jerome, one touch for Sharpie, who will bring it forward for Jacksonville. Sharpie's done a lot of running, especially since moving from the left side to the right side. McInerney now out wide for Mikey Melvin, the former Nice High School and Clemson star. Here's Portilla. Connor Doyle. Melvin will bring it forward.
It's positive.
Now Gebhard. Another corner coming for Jacksonville. Miami continues to defend in the box very well. The Armada continue to give themselves opportunities on corners and set pieces.
Yeah, Gebhardt's been good in the flank all day today. Had a little, was down for about 10 minutes, but he's been definitely very bright the second half. I'd like to see him take that ball to the end line and cut it back with his left foot.
Another substitution for Miami United. Diego Reskin coming on. Another corner for Jacksonville. This one headed away. Castellanos keeps possession, stayed with it, and wins another corner.
I'd like to see the corner count. That's got to be almost near 10.
Castellanos, you can see number 7 for Jacksonville. And that shirt, it looks like it's already been through the laundry. It's so caked in sweat.
And you look at Yuma with his long sleeve base layer on. Hasn't broken a sweat. That's what experience gets you.
A little two-touch from the corner. Now Jerome. And a little over-ambitious there for Meshack.
Not a bad idea, but none of the forwards are on the same page. They expected Meshack to do Meshack and kick it as hard as he could towards the goal, which history says that's normally what he would do.
The odds are.
Yes.
Final 2.5 minutes of regulation time. We've not seen a goal yet. Now a counter opportunity on a breakaway for Miami United. This is Shamar. And ran out of room.
Good defending. Good recovery from Sharpie and Meshack to get back, because that was very, very dangerous. Sharpie coming from his right back position to cover and force the ball out of bounds.
And again, you've got Miami United kicking extra balls around on the pitch.
Absolutely.
And now Shamar goes down. Apparently, him kicking an extra ball onto the pitch was a dangerous moment for him. He's on the deck.
Interesting to see how much time the referee adds. I would probably say a minimum of 5. I mean, you've had 5 substitutions, this injury, balls out of play, slow restarts. I would expect at least another 4 to 5 minutes.
Shelton Shamar, the Jamaican. Now finally back up. He's a sub, so you'd hardly think he was gassed at this point.
That's gamesmanship.
Another Miami sub coming up, by the way. And it will be Sekani Sinclair coming on and he's going to replace Shamar. So, subbing for a sub.
Must have pulled something, have a muscle injury, soft tissue injury or something.
Well, you saw him go down out of the corner of my eye, and...
Yeah, he must have, when he tried to run that ball down, he may have just tweaked something. And
yep. In the NPSL, 7 substitutions available, so you can sub everybody. So not as rare to see a sub subbed out in this league compared to leagues like the NASL and MLS and other FIFA leagues where it's 3. We've hit the end of regulation time. 4 minutes of stoppage time going to be added here in Jacksonville. Here's Connor Doyle. A little too much juice on that one and easily handled.
Surprised to see only 4 minutes.
Yeah, a little surprised as well. And now you would imagine that barring a great opportunity for a counter of some kind or a slip up in the back, Miami United is definitely going to be willing to play for a 0-0 here.
Absolutely. Keep it tight at the back and just...
The Armada will not be satisfied with that. They'll be going for a goal here late. McInerney, slide tackle. And then sent out by Portilla. There'll be a throw in for Miami United. Diego Reskin will handle the duties. 28-year-old who didn't play last game, who was suspended after yellow card accumulation. Miami United player goes down. This one chipped toward the box, headed away by Mikey Melvin. Meshack Jerome able to position to redirect it for Jacksonville.
That was nice.
Nicely done by Castellanos. He's seen a couple of nifty little moments of skill in this contest.
That was a great, clean little piece of skill, a little outside the toe flick to scoop it up over the tackle and spin out. It's when you try 100 times and it comes off once. Well, for me at least.
Others may have better success or worse.
Yes.
Now to Gebhardt. Back to Melvin. The Armada pushing bodies forward. Just 2 defenders back right now for Jacksonville. Here's Gebhardt.
Need a combination.
Chips one, headed away, and the offside flag up on Kilduff.
Like to see a combination to get Gebhardt running at the back, at the end line again. The players are there, just have to try to force the combination, but try to use extra attackers to move defenders. You don't actually have to pass the ball to combine. You can move defenders with a body feint or something, but just settling for a service into the box to one player is just not good enough.
Would make sense perhaps for a Portilla-Gebhardt combination on that side.
Absolutely.
Yuma got pushed, didn't like it. McCauley getting a talking to. Yuma saying he got hit in the head.
Back in the neck head area, yeah.
Armada don't want to slow this thing up. They want to make sure they have every opportunity to try to get that stoppage time goal and take control of the division.
Well, Meshack can flip the field pretty easily here. Don't play it short.
Yuma going forward. Mikey Melvin going forward.
Jerome motioning to get forward to win the second ball.
McCauley standing right there at his own risk in front of Meshack Jerome. And there's the yellow card on McCauley.
It's silly yellow cards like that that lead to accumulation suspensions that drive coaches crazy.
Here's Jerome, long ball. Second ball handled by Sharpie. Now Yuma. Meshack again for Kilduff. Little header. Castellanos on the run. Got a piece of it. And Peterson on a ball that didn't look like it was going to be on frame. Turns it aside. And another corner coming for Jacksonville here in the dying moments.
Yeah, good save from Peterson. Good build-up. Good second effort to keep the play alive. But this could be the last chance on a set piece for the Armada tonight.
And Connor Doyle will take it again. Substitution coming for Jacksonville here. Castellanos coming off.
This is probably just a guarantee that the corner gets played.
And Giovanni Vasquez coming in at 6'2". You also have more size than Castellanos, so another big body coming into the box. Only Yuma and Meshack Jerome are more than 20 yards away from the goal right now. This one chipped in, headed. It was McInerney. Didn't get it redirected as he wanted.
Yeah, he crossed the front post. You know, he went for goal in the header. When you cross the front post, you should actually look to flick that ball on. But the service was a little flat and a little too much outswing. He didn't start close enough to the end line, and I think McInerney did as best he could on the service.
So Peterson will send this one forward. How much more stoppage time? No more is the answer. 95 minutes, no goals. The Armada, nil. Miami United, nil. Both clubs continue to battle. Jacksonville without a win against Miami United this year. And the Armada will be looking up at Miami FC in the Sunshine Division standings in the morning. Jacksonville's next action will be coming up on Wednesday here at Hodges Stadium against the only team to have beaten them in NASL NPSL play this year, Palm Beach United. That will be a 7:30 kickoff. And the Armada will look to get back in the goal-scoring column after a 0-0 final here. Ryan, your thoughts?
I think that the shape change in the second half definitely worked for the Armada. They were a little bit more dangerous. You know, but all credit to Miami United for being very organized and disciplined defensively and, you know, to grind out that 0-0 draw on the road, a point well earned.
For Ryan Patridge and our entire crew, Cole Pepper saying thanks for watching Jacksonville Armada Soccer. Have a great night.